everyone, today we're catching up with the winner of the 2025 Configurable Logic Design Challenge. Now, over the course of 6 months, we received more than 250 submissions and watched 41 finalists bring their ideas to life for a chance to win one of our top five prizes. Now, today we're calling up Mark, our first place winner. Wait, can't we just go talk to him in person?
Hi, Mark.
Hey.
First off, congratulations on winning the CLB Design Challenge.
Yeah, thank you. I'm excited.
And before we get started on talking about your design, could you tell us a little bit more about yourself?
Yeah, so I am the General Manager and Director of Engineering here at Marcus Engineering. So we're a electrical engineering consulting company. We work primarily in medical devices, military, aerospace, stuff where life and safety is on the line.
So what got you interested in the CLB and this challenge? Was it something that you've worked on before? What sparked your curiosity?
Yeah, so we use the core independent peripherals and lots of other PICs before and get tons and tons of value, being able to do stuff that you can't do on a processor. And something we've always wanted is an FPGA fabric in our part or glue logic for our system. Mm-hmm. That's why we're so excited about the CLB, to really give us that FPGA fabric that we can embed inside our part. One of the hardest parts about adding even a small FPGA is it has tons of power consumption compared to your processor. And so by putting it in the processor, we can now get that glue logic even in the lowest power designs that we work on.
Mm-hmm. And something that you did with your design is build a 16-bit DAC on an 8-bit MCU. So how were you able to do that? And can you tell us a little bit more about your design?
Yeah, so when I saw we have 32 CLBs in the system, that's exactly enough to build a 16-bit full adder if I use every single CLB on the whole part. So by doing that, we can squeeze in a DAC inside the part. And it already has an 8-bit DAC, but for lots of applications where you need like really precise sensing or really fine-tuned control, things like that, or even just more DAC channels, getting a Sigma-Delta DAC inside the part is super useful. Here, let me show you. So even though we have this onboard DAC, it's only 8 bits. So you can see it's got big steps in it. So a 16-bit DAC gives you much finer control that you need for lots of instrumentation applications. This chip is actually cheaper than any 16-bit DAC you can buy right now. We can even play music on it.
Now, one of the coolest things about the CLB is how it doesn't use any external components and you can build peripherals inside of it. So how were you able to use that flexibility to build your DAC?
Yeah, so the nice thing about how it's built is it acts just like a peripheral on the chip. All you do is you write the 16-bit output word into the CLB and everything happens autonomously from there. You don't need any processor input to run the whole system.
Another strength of the CLB is the fast and reliable response times. Did that play a part in your design?
Yeah, so with a Sigma-Delta ADC, you want to run it as fast as possible. So we're actually able to run it at the full 32 megahertz, way faster than you could ever run the CPU on this part to get really wide bandwidth and a really clean output. Yeah, so we can use the CLB synthesizer to open up this design. It's actually just a Verilog block inside. So we use the entire CLB to route this. So we can't actually synthesize it. We need to place it by hand. But we can make a test bench inside of the CLB synthesizer and actually simulate what the design will look like. If we look at the output here, we can see the input stimulus. We're generating a sine wave that goes peak to peak. And we can look at the output of the pulse density modulation from the Sigma-Delta DAC to see that we're actually synthesizing that output and helps debug issues like selecting the right output, make sure that we're grabbing the overflow instead of the MSB, things like that. We can really see inside of the CLB design to understand what's going on and troubleshoot issues and probe things that we could never probe on the real system.
So how much CPU does it need, does the DAC need to run?
So like I said, it's completely autonomous. You don't need to use the CPU at all. You just write the output word and everything is handled for you. So that means you can run the DAC even when the CPU is off to get really low power operation.
Oh, that's awesome. Mark, thanks so much for being with us here today and sharing your design journey with us and to show us what's possible with the CLB.
Yeah, thanks for coming down to CS. We're excited to have you guys.
And congrats again for winning. If you'd like to try it out for yourself, click the link below.
Think you've got what it takes to win big? Stay tuned for future challenges.